what the business do. What do we speak about? We don't speak about, do we need sustainability? Of course we do. But here we are bankers, asset managers, specialists, consultants. And I think today we want to dig a little more into the concrete discussions. We must do it. From a business point of view, once more, it's obvious. It's obvious for the political leadership. Unfortunately, not unanimously. The US leadership has taken a different view. But we know at the same time that the US investors, the American mayors, governors, the public opinion are much committed to the debate about sustainability. And I hope they will join back under your leadership, Madam, the group, to be sure it works well. So I'm not very pleased about the decision of the American leadership. At the same time, I know that we shall do the job. And all of us, we shall do the job. So what does it mean? It means the capacity to make investments valid for the long term, good for the investors, good for the consumers, good for the people. It has a lot to do with questions related to technology. Technology brings changes. It's a massive opportunity. And we see in our industry, in banking, the changes enabled by technology. And we need to work more on this. And we need to speak about this, about environment, about many questions. Technology is changing the world. At the same time, we need to do our job in banking. BNP Paribas is extremely committed to this. We can act at least through three dimensions. One is, you know it well, financing, making money available, equity and loans. This is not always easy, and we need to understand well what's happening, and we need to be committed at listening carefully to those who manage projects and have visions. And bankers must be able to take risks to support the projects. This is a commitment for us. We can act through policies, not the public policies. This is your challenge, madam, but the private sector policies. What do we finance? Do we finance coal? Do we finance pipelines? Do we finance energy savings? All these questions, we are working very hard on them. It's not always easy. We need to listen to you to understand the technology, the challenges, the views people make on environment, long-term views. I've been working on these questions now probably for 15 or 20 years. I was president of the EBRD before, and I've worked a lot on these questions. It is difficult, and the only way to move forward for banks is to do it with you, in clear understanding of what should be done. And then banks must be absolutely crystal clear about what they do and what they don't do. The third action, which is possible for us, and we do, is to bridge project managers and investors. This is a big task we have, and probably the forum today is a good example of this, putting people together and make sure they understand each other and work together. But, and this is my last point, this is extremely demanding. I don't want to be somber early in the morning, but this is demanding. Demanding for many reasons. We need to change our habits, way of living. will have a big impact. You know, sustainability is not business as usual. We need to understand this, each of us, and we need to understand what's going to happen for the clients. Good and less good. Good or difficult or challenging. We need to understand it's going to be demanding on the organization of the industrial and service processes. I will not give you examples, you understand what I mean. In the mobility industry, it has a big impact, and it will have even tomorrow a bigger impact with the electrical cars. And it has a big impact on people, workers, their capacity to integrate and work with this. I say this because sustainability will not be a win-win process if people lose too much. And sometimes I see in the population that people agree, but then when you go to specific projects, they are frightened. And it's our job. And I say this is the job of a bank like BNP Paribas to make the two compatible, to pay a lot of attention to the human dimension, to make sure that people understand, share the same views, receive what is needed to adapt their skills, and also to make sure that there's nobody left aside, not only people, but also territories. I'm always surprised that large cities may benefit a lot out of the new technologies, but the small cities are being left aside. This is not fair, if I may use a strange word, but this is dangerous. Nobody must be left aside of sustainability and the opportunity of sustainability. This is about money, return on investment, risk, but this is also about social inclusion. And if we don't understand this well, we shall miss the target. I know this is very important for the government. And I will not be long on this, but I can say that I have a lot of respect for the decisions which are being taken by the government, because they are designed at the tax level, at the labor level, to facilitate that process, to help creation and innovation in a sustainable way. But it is up to us to do the job. The government can do a lot, but we do the job creation, and we make sure that there is social inclusion. And this is why I do pay a lot of attention to education, to training. We need to insist on this more and more, because that will be the key for success of tomorrow. We are very lucky this morning and honored to have you, Madame. Madame Boisson has agreed to come and speak with us about your vision, about the vision of the government. You will allow me to say, using my age, that you have a long experience. And I'm always impressed, you know, Madame Poisson is a young minister and a young and bright MP, but has a long experience in the civil society and in companies. And that's key. Speeches are good, Madame, but understanding the reality, the ground, the nitty-gritty of the hopes, expectations, and difficulties is key when we speak about policy making. And we know you have it, and you have the passion of a young minister who is going to deliver a lot. So we shall listen to you very carefully. Thank you for being with us this morning. The floor is yours.
Mesdames et messieurs, Monsieur le Président, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to speak in English for a while, not the entire speech though. It's for me really a great honor and a real pleasure to be here in front of you today. And I really mean it, because I have to say that I'm really impressed